فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، وإن شرح هذا الكتاب النزهة النظر في توضيح نخبة الفكر في مصطلح أهل الأثر، written by الإمام حافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله. We spoke about the statement of the author where he says, فَإِنْ جُمِعَ فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ حَيْثُ التَّفَرُّدُ وَإِلَّا فِي بِاعْتِبَارِ سْنَادَيْنِ. What we mentioned is that Hafidh ibn Hajar, we defined what Sahih means and its types. There's Sahih which is لِذَاتِهِ and Sahih which is لِغَيْرِهِ. We even spoke about حسن لذاته and حسن لغيره. The two types of حسن as well. So we talked about the two types of صحيح, and we also spoke about the two types of حسن. We've explained that. And we told the difference that they are. And then we said we have an issue here. And that is, we have a scholar by the name of Tirmidhi, who took those two terms that we define and he emerged them and turned it to be one usage. So we see one hadith, him saying, this hadith is what? Hasan or Sahih. So we're now in a position of hayra, confusion. Why? Because we said that Hasan means something and we said Sahih means something. How is it that he has made them both into the same definition? How is it that he has used both of them? Were two different words, and he has used it for one hadith. Hafidh ibn Hajar tried to explain that in his kitab. He said there's two responses. Hafidh ibn Hajar, he said the first one is, if the hadith has only one chain, if the hadith is only one chain, then فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ. If the hadith has only one chain, then Tirmidhi is in a state of confusion. He doesn't have the ability to give it one of the two descriptions. He's unable to say it is sahih or he's unable to say hasan. So Tirmidhi is in a state of what? Taraddud. He said that's if the hadith has one sanad. Good. But he said, وَإِلَّا if the hadith has more than one chain, فَبِعْتِبَارِ إِسْنَادَيْنِ then he is, now Tirmidhi is trying to say one sanad or one narration is Hasan and the other narration is what? Sahih. That's the explanation and that's the final conclusion given by Hafidh ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah. That's his response. In last lesson, I said that the statement of Hafidh ibn Hajar لا يشفي من علة ولا يروي من غلة. The statement of Hafidh ibn Hajar here does not really answer this issue. And as he himself, Ibn Hajar, has tried to criticize those previous scholars that came before him who tried to answer that statement of Tirmidhi, Hasan and Sahih, and Ibn Hajar, he refuted everyone else's argument. If you look at his Nuzhat al-Nadhar, he proves their understanding to be wrong. And this is what he came with, Ibn Hajar. His one now is also under the what? Under question. And it's not sufficing for the following reasons. Let's take each answer that he gave. Let's look at the first answer, which is if the hadith only has one sanad, or if the hadith has been narrated through one chain. Then Tirmidhi is in a state of what? But Tirmidhi is talking about bi'atibari wasf al-rawi. There's a narrator in there who some scholars have what? Have given him the what? His precision. Because remember we said the hasan and the sahih, we said what's the difference? It's only the precision, it's the dhabt. It's the memory, right? So he's saying Tirmidhi is here. Are we all together? That's the first answer Ibn Hajar gave. That Tirmidhi is in a state of confusion. If the hadith comes in one chain, then there's an individual in that hadith whose precision, his memory, some scholars are saying it's a level of sahih. Some scholars are saying his memory is not to that level. So they're taking it, if the memory is not to the highest level, are we all together? Then it becomes what? Hasanun, it becomes Hasan. And if it's to the top, what does it become? Sahih. That's the only difference between Hasan and Sahih. Remember we said that, right? So Ibn Tirmidhi, when he's saying, so this hadith is only one chain, Tirmidhi is saying that this person's memory is where the khilaf is coming. Some scholars are saying that his memory is, mashallah, and some are saying, fihi ma fihi, in it is what is in it. So Tirmidhi is in a state of what? Taraddud. He can't. Now we're going to show that is not, that's incorrect for Ibn Hajar to think that. And these objections come forward regarding that concept of Imam Ibn Hajar. The following reason, number one. It is found after following Sunan al-Tirmidhi. If you follow up Sunan al-Tirmidhi and you look at, okay, the answer that Ibn Hajar is given, you see that Tirmidhi actually uses Hasanun Sahihun for a hadith which are muttafaqun ala sihatiha. Which are muttafaqun ala sihatiha. It's authentication that this hadith is sahih, is unanimously agreed upon. And he's still using Hasanun Sahih in it. And you guys all know that a hadith, there are some ahadith, the chains that it consists of are called the what? Asahul Asanid. Iraqi says in his Alfiyah, Imsakuna an hukmina ala sanad bi annahu asahu mutlaqan waqad khada bihi qawmun faqila malikun an nafi'in bima rawahu anhu nasikun. Nasik, he is Ibn Umar. Until he carries on. There are ahadith which we consider to be what? Asahul Asanid. Asahul Asanid means what? This chain is one of the most authentic chains there are out there. And from the chains that are considered to be asahh al-asanid, they are considered to be one of the most authentic chain of narrations are Nafi' an ibn Umar. Sorry, Malik an Nafi' an ibn Umar. Malik an Nafi' an ibn Umar. Are we all together? That sanad is called asahh al-asanid. No one differs that this chain is authentic. No one disputes the authenticity of this. They're just disputing, is it the most authentic chain or is it not? But they all, this is muttafaqun ala sahatiha. Scholars unanimously, they agree upon that. Also, one of the sanid that are muttafaqun ala sahatiha, that its chain is the most authentic, is unanimously agreed upon, but it is different. Is it the most authentic or is it not? Is Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, if he narrates from Salim, and Salim narrates from his father. Zuhriyun and Salimin and Abihi al-Barri. Salim, if he narrates from, Zuhri, Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri narrates from Salim. Salim narrates from who? His father. This chain is also asah al-asanid. It's from the most authentic chains that are out there. Okay? Scholars do not differ that this is sanad is authentic. They only differ. Some are saying, no. Are we all together? Some are saying what? Malik and Nafi' ibn Umar is the asah al-asani, the most authentic chain. And others are like, la, Zuhriyun an Salim an Abihi. And others are saying others. There are many. Like in Iraq, he doesn't like the idea of saying this sanad is, he said, imsakuna, we withhold. And imsakuna an hukmina ala sanad. We hold from this statement of saying that this chain is the most authentic, But he said, إمساكنا عن حكمنا على سند بأنه أصح مطلقا وقد خاض به قومون. That a group of scholars خاضوا, they indulged into this. And each one started to give. Bukhari has a view, which one is the most authentic? Ahmed rahimahullah has a view of what is most authentic. And others. Are we all together? ولذلك I advise you to go to the kitab Al-Ba'ith al-Hathith Iqtisar al-Ulum al-Hadith by Ahmed Shakir. Ahmed Shakir brings over 10 different chains which are called Asah al-Asanid. Are we all together? Some of you might ask yourself here, what's the benefit of knowing the chains which are the most authentic? What benefit do I gain from it? It's beneficial. Why is it beneficial? Because when it happens that there's a chain and this chain, it opposes each other, عند الترجيح will benefit you. When you want to strengthen one over the other. Are we all together? Strengthening one narration over the other. This would help you because this is unanimously agreed upon is authentication. Are we all together? So it's only beneficial عند الترجيح. It's only beneficial when you're trying to strengthen between the narrations that are out there. Anyways, I'm getting sidetracked. Coming back again. So we find Tirmidhi using in his Sunan a hadith which are narrated Malik an Nafi' an Ibn Umar. He's saying Hassan wa Sahih. Salim an Abi Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri and Salim an Abihi. We find Tirmidhi using this for Hassan wa Sahih. Hey, what do we do here? Are we all together? Can this be taraddud from Tirmidhi? When this is, it is authentic, it is by consensus of the ulama, by the scholars, they don't differ on it. And a majority of it, he uses Hasan al-Sahih for that. Rather, a hadith which it's found in Bukhari and Muslim, Tirmidhi if he narrates in his Sunan, he still uses Hasan al-Sahih. So Hafiz ibn Hajar's answer here, this is a problem. These are from the things that yaridu alayhi al-umur. These are matters that come forward. This is from the things that come forward. The second thing that comes from it. Tirmidhi is an imam mujtahid. Tirmidhi is a what? He's a scholar who has reached in ilm al-hadith. He's a what? He's a mujtahid. Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala. He has reached a level where he's going to strengthen opinions. How is he going to leave the majority of his book in a state of doubt? Would he? He's an imam mujtahid. He's a scholar who has reached darajatul ijtihad. He's not a muqallid. Tirmidhi will not blind follow. Some scholars have strengthened it. Some scholars have disputed it. Tirmidhi, bighaddi nadar, scholars who've reached that level of ijtihad, they don't look at what other scholars have said. They don't. They look at the evidence themselves. So here the question is that it's as though Ibn Hajar is stripping away from Tirmidhi, huh? This level that he has, which is that he's an imam, which is mujtahid. So if he's a mujtahid, Tirmidhi, he's going to have to give his own personal reason, independent reasoning regarding this particular hadith. And he's not going to look at Tirmidhi, ما عند النقاد, what other scholars have taken into consideration. He would choose from within that. He would choose from within that. Even then, which is still the second point, if Tirmidhi is trying to bring the khilaf in this issue, because if he says that this hadith is sahih and some are considering it to be hasan, which is what Ibn Hajar is saying, then why does he bring the khilaf in the hadiths which he only says sahih? Some of the hadith that he uses, that he brings only sahih in there, some scholars have differed in its authentication as well. Why doesn't he bring also khilaf in that one? Why is he only bringing this so-called khilaf in some of the narrations? Are we together? Also, the other question at that particular point is that if he's bringing hasanun sahihun, then why do we not ever find him bringing hasanun da'ifun, masahihun? Da'ifun. Why doesn't he also bring some scholars that reached, some are saying it's da'if. So why is he only bringing the khilaf of sahih and hasan? And why is he not bringing the Sahih and Da'if as well. Are we all together, brothers? These are matters that are coming to Ibn Hajar now. Responses are needed from him. Rahimahullahu ta'ala. Point number three. So that's all of the khilaf that he's saying, Ibn Hajar, that's all falls under the second point. Number three. What happens is that, from the statement of Ibn Hajar, is that Tirmidhi, being an ala imamatihi wa jalalati fi hadha al-fan, being imam in this particular field, and how noble he is in this field, لم يترجح عنده, nothing has become clear to him. In many of places in his own book, by bringing these two descriptions, which is Hassan and Sahih. So Tirmidhi has no position in many of that hadith in his Sahih, in his Sunan. Number four, why has he not even once at least brought the term wow? Why didn't he say Hassanun wa Sahihun? Or why hasn't he said Hassanun أو صحيح, which can show تردد. Oh, why not once has he not brought that? Why has he always left it like this? That's also, that's إشكالات that has come regarding the first answer he gave. Are we all together? That if the hadith is one chain, Tirmidhi is in a state of what? Tirmidhi is in a state of تردد. The second point of the hadith book, the second answer he gave, which is that if the hadith is more than one, if the hadith is more than one, then he's talking about bi'atibari isnadin, and then bi'atibari isnadin akhar. When he says hasanan, hasan, he means one chain is hasan, and sahih, he means the other chain is what? Sahih. That's the second answer that he gave, right? Also, يَرِدُ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرَانِ, two matters come forward. I'm going to focus on these two points, inshallah ta'ala. The first one is Tirmidhi's real definition of Hassan. Are we all together? Tirmidhi's definition of Hassan and what he defines Hassan is that the hadith has to be more than one chain, aslan. The definition of Tirmidhi to be Hassan is not the definition that we understand to be what? Hassan. He's got his own definition of Hassan. For an Imam Tirmidhi, Hassan has to be more than one chain. Rather, Tirmidhi hadith is Hassan when three things are combined in it, or three characteristics are in it. Number one, أَلَّا يَكُونَ فِي إِسْنَادِ مَنْ يُتَهَمُ بِالْكَذِبِ. Number one is that it is not in the chain a person who is suspected of lying. That's the first characteristics that is needed for the hadith to be Hassan according to Tirmidhi. أَلَّا يَكُونَ فِي إِسْنَادِهِ مَنْ يُتَّهَمُ بِالْكَذِبِ. That there should not be in the chain of narrations anyone who is suspected to be a liar. Number two is وَأَلَّا يَكُونَ الْحَدِيثُ شَاذًا. And that the hadith should not also be opposing other hadiths. It can't be what? It can't be shad. It can't be shad. And number three is وَأَنْ يُرْوَى مِثْلُ ذَلِكَ الْحَدِيثِ أَوْ نَحْوُهُ مِنْ وَجْهٍ آخَرَ فَصَاعِدًا. Number three is that this hadith, this particular hadith, a hadith like it has to be narrated from another chain. With those three conditions, a hadith is Hassan to Tirmidhi. Are we all together? So when Ibn Hajar is saying that if the chain is more than two, more than one, then he's looking at one to be Hassan and the other one to be Sahih. Aslan, Hassan to him is what? More than one. Aslan. It's actually what? More than one. So that's point number one. Point number two is that based on Tirmidhi's definition of Hassan, based on the definition that Imam Tirmidhi brings forward, it necessitates that the hadith in which Tirmidhi is describing to be Hassan is itself not reached hasan because of itself. In other words, it's not hasan lidati. It reached hasan by what? In ضم بعض إلى بعض. Other narrations came together, and so it pushed it together. So it cannot have come the husn, but it being hasan is not hasan lidati. It didn't come from hasan lidati. So now that we've shown that Ibn Hajar rahimahullah's response is not what? Is not لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع. لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع. It's not a good response. رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. Ibn Hajar's statement is not sufficing. It doesn't suffice us. So what do we do here? We need an answer to this. So hey, last lesson I asked if you guys to research, hey, who found an answer? I asked if you guys can go check up, find out. Hey, who's found out? When we question Ibn Hajar based on what he said, first of all, what I want you guys to understand is that, and I want you guys to really ponder on it, is that you might find one or two, a group of a hadith which fall according to Ibn Hajar's way of looking at it. Are we all together? And what he's saying. But that doesn't mean that's what Tirmidhi means. Because if it was, then it would have gone through all of the book, right? Then you wouldn't find any discrepancy. So we're talking about the overall what? Observation of the whole book. And I advise you all to ponder on this point. As Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, he said he refused, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala refused to leave anything in perfection other than the Quran. Only person who has perfection is who? The statement of Allah. If everybody who spoke, or everybody who wrote something, their book was 100%. 100%. Are we all together? Then what value would the Qur'an hold? The value in the Qur'an is that there's no book like it. That there is no book like it. Nothing's like it. It's the best, the Qur'an. And every person who speaks, their statement is not outside discussion. كَائِنًا مَنْ كَانَ whoever they are. صح? Whoever it may be, however high he may be, what he says is open to be looked at other than Allah and His Messenger. Everybody else is open for discussion and dialogue. لِذَلِكَ الإمام مالك what did he say? كل يؤخذ من قوله. Everybody's statement is either taken or it is what? كل يؤخذ من قوله ويرد. Every person's statement is either taken or it is what? Rejected. And then he said إلا صاحب هذا القبر, except the man or the individual of this grave, referring to who? The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. The only person whose statement is only taken, no ifs, no buts, is who? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ولذلك الإمام الذهبي, when he spoke about the biography of Ibn Taymiyyah, and Dhahabi was amazed with what he saw from Ibn Taymiyyah, صح? He was shocked what he saw from this man. So he said, any hadith that what? That Ibn Taymiyyah does not know is not a hadith. Any hadith that Ibn Taymiyyah does not know is not a hadith. Ya ikhwah, scholars then done ta'qib on it. Illa anna al-ihatata lillah. The only one who's actually encompassed everything, who knows everything, is Allah. Na'am, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala qalla. Those littles, something might slip from him. Are we all together? There's a place in Majmu' al-Fatawa, once I was reading it, Ibn Taymiyyah is narrating hadith. He said, وَأَظُنُّهُ رَوَاهُ. And he mentions a Mazdar. He said, I think it's narrated in that book. He mentions all the other places, but he said, I think it's narrated there. I went and checked it. No, Allahu Akbar. Are we all together? That's it. Even when he thinks he's right. Huh? Are we all together? And when we're 100% sure, we're wrong sometimes. Huh? Like even then we say al-ihatatu lillah. Only Allah is the one and His messenger. Everybody else, Ibn Hajar, this field of hadith, what's it for him? This is his field. It's no one else's field. It is Ibn Hajar's field. Hada maydanu. This is his field of expertise. I say this many times. Ibn Khaldun said, "Sahih al-Bukhari yudainun ala hadhihi al-ummah." Sahih al-Bukhari is a debt on this ummah. Sah? Al-Imam al-Bukhari has established a proof against us. When he combined this authentic book for us, he has placed a debt on everybody's neck that they need to pay back. And then Sakhawiyu came and he said, "Law ra'a Ibn Khaldun," if Ibn Khaldun was to see ma sana'a Ibn Hajar, that which Ibn Hajar has done, la ra'a anna dayna tuwfiya haqq al-wafa. He would have realized that the debt has been paid on our behalf. By who? Ibn Hajar. How has he paid it off for us? By explaining it, Fathul Bari. The explanation that he has put on it has paid back Bukhari for us. Is that a light matter to say that Bukhari has been paid back? Are we all together? Fathul Bari, there's no book like it.